Again, thanks, Madam Speaker. My name is Gustavo Grau. I'm actually an international student. I come from Venezuela, and I've lived in the past 4 years in a country that has seen but one government or one form of government. For the past 6 years, its public powers have been compromised, in my opinion, to favor one political majority. And I just wanted to ask you, in the past recent events, in the 14th of April, would you recognize or not recognize the currently elected government in Venezuela? A second question would be, currently, I think we have a political crisis in our hands, and what would be your advice to achieve bipartisanship and to reconstruct political institutions that have been severely damaged?
Yeah. Thank you. The gentleman is from Venezuela, and he was asking what my attitude was toward the elections of April 14th. Well, I think that we, two things. One, we have to see what the legitimate results are of the election of April 14th in Venezuela. Also, we have to be careful, as some Americans are even saying, oh, it's just the U.S. trying to throw its weight around in Latin America, and so encouraging people to go into the streets against who was perceived to be the winner. So it's a very careful balance that has to be there. We certainly want to respect democratically elected governments, but we also want to make sure that that's what they are, democratically elected governments. And we don't want anybody to think that the U.S. is there to overturn such a government. On the other hand, just to make a distinction between the United States and when you talk about what we do to encourage bipartisanship, the more the public is aware, the public sentiment is everything, the more the public is aware. Now, I visited Venezuela it must be like 10 years ago when, and it was just so interesting. It was one of the few countries where the middle class was shrinking and the poor were growing, but the government was putting out the thought that things were getting better. So it's really hard. That's why information, knowledge, trying to do it in a way that is not political, it probably is, the truth will set everybody free, hopefully, in that regard.